Hello students, so in the previous video we had started with our chapter third level and we got to know that yes, this chapter is going to be about time travel, where the protagonist Charlie, he experiences something very different, something very new, where he is transported to some other time. So this was his experience of time travel, and he comes back and he talks about his experience to his psychiatrist friend, to other friends. Nobody believes, and psychiatrist friend, he does not believe in, but he gives one reason behind this experience. Okay, though Charlie is not agreeing with that. Now we start with a we can say second paragraph, okay, page one. But that's the reason, he said, and my friends all agreed. Everything points to it, they claimed. My stamp collecting, for example, that's a temporary refuge from reality. Now, what reason the Sam psychiatrist friend had given? He had told that because you are caught in the web of this, we can say, complicated life. There is competitions, cutthroat competition, busy life, hectic life, and that's why maybe you wanted to run away from this kind of life. You may not agree, you may not be even knowing it, but unconsciously somewhere you wanted, okay, to be away from this kind of life, even for few days only. Okay, and that's why maybe you had this experience. Okay, moreover, then they said that you have one more hobby also, one more thing in you, that is your hobby of stamp collection. Now actually they feel that when we have some hobby, okay, this hobby also is a kind of, we can say, relief for us. Why? Because we busy ourselves with our hobby, it means we are away from our hectic life, okay, from our hectic schedule, and maybe this is kind of relief for us, that we spend some time, okay, with our hobby. This hobby can be playing a game or listening to music or something else. Here, this Charlie, he is having the hobby of stamp collecting. Okay, so what stamp collection actually does, when you are collecting the stamps, it means you have stamps from many, we can say, different times. Like, you know, whenever something great happens, the nations, they release their new stamps, okay, just to commemorate those, we can say, events. So maybe now when you look at those stamps, naturally the year is written, maybe the name of the year, name of the event is also written, and sometimes you go back to that olden time. So when you are having many stamps of naturally olden time, so this is very obvious that sometime you are transported to that different time. So they say that because you have this stamp collection, okay, that's why maybe you experience that, because it shows that you want some kind of refuge from your, we can say, this kind of hectic life. A temporary refuge from reality. Underline this. Okay, for example, that's a temporary refuge from reality. Reality is real world, that you are having a hectic schedule. Okay, so you want to be away from this schedule. Okay, and that's why you want something new. And something new can be your hobby. You spend some time, okay, with your hobby, and then you feel that yes, you have new energies. Okay, so re-energizes these hobby. Okay, this hobby will re-energize you. So this is what you feel, and that's why he says this is temporary refuge. Okay, refuge means shelter. You get a kind of shelter. Okay, you get a kind of relief, though this is very temporary, but even then, this maybe half an hour or 1 hour with your hobby is more than enough to give you new energies for the next maybe 1 week, that way. Well, maybe, but my grandfather didn't need any refuge from reality. Charlie says, okay, maybe this is true with me, because maybe I have this kind of hobby, and maybe you say that hobby means I want a kind of refuge, and because I am always searching for this kind of refuge, and you say that maybe because of that only I had this experience. Okay, this is why my grandfather was having then this kind of hobby, because his hobby also was stamp collection, and he had got his stamp collection and nearly all the stamps, and this hobby also he had got from his grandfather. He says, but his time was, things were pretty nice and peaceful. He says his time was not that hectic time. Okay, there was no competition. It was a very peaceful time. They had a very good life. But even then, my grandfather was having this hobby. So according to Charlie, hobby doesn't mean that we want to run away from the realities. Okay, it's not that, that's why we have some hobby. From all I hear, okay, and he started my collection. It's nice collection too, blocks of four of Piketty every US issue, first day covers. Moreover, He said that my grandfather used to have first day covers. Okay, in the later part of this chapter, we will be, you know, I will be giving the details of first day covers, because though you underline here also, because again, this is 2 marker. Okay, 2 marks question, important question. Okay, what do you know about first day covers? So later on, I will tell. So first day covers and so on. President Roosevelt collected stamps too, you know. Anyway, now he says, though he's not fully convinced with what Sam said, but he could not say anything. He could not do anything. He just, you know, narrated his experience. Now here, he's narrating what happened actually, what kind of experience he had. Now he's detailing that experience, which he has already narrated to his friends and Sam. Anyway, here's what happened at Grand Central Station. One night, last summer, I worked late at the office. He was late in the office. I was in a hurry to get up to uptown to my apartment. So I decided to take the subway from Grand Central because it's faster than the bus. So he said that day I was already late in my office. So I thought that today, instead of bus, I should take this subway train. So this is what he decided. Now I don't know why this should have happened to me. I'm just an ordinary guy named Charlie, 31 years old. He said, I decided to take the train, okay, to reach my home at the earliest. He says, I do not know why this experience, you know, I had, why this happened to me, because it's not that I was looking something special on that particular day. No, I was just looking very normal like other people, okay, and I am moreover also, I am a very normal person. My name is Charlie, I am 31 years old, so many people are 31, okay, and so many people are having Charlie name, but even then, this happened to me. And I was wearing a tan gabardine suit and a straw hat with a fancy band. Now he talks about his own dress sense. He says, I was wearing tan color. Many people wear tan color. I was wearing gabardine suit. Many people, you know, wear this kind of suit. I was wearing straw hat. Many people wear straw hat. Why he's telling, he's trying to say that there was nothing different in me. But even then, I had that experience. I passed a dozen men who looked just like me. And I wasn't trying to escape from anything. I just wanted to get home to Luza, my wife. He says that this Sam friend, what he had told, that you wanted to be maybe, you know, away from your hectic life and you wanted to run away from this present reality. And that's why he said, no, that day I was not trying to run away from any reality. I just wanted to get back to my wife at the earliest. Okay, and I was not thinking anything else. But still this happened. Now, how it happened? Now, he wanted to take the train. That's why he said, I turned into Grand Central from Vanderbilt Avenue. So, from this particular entry, okay, he entered to that gate, entered to that Grand Central station and went down the steps to the first level. And he said, from that, I went down to the first level. Okay, where you take trains like the 20th century. Then I walked down another flight to the second level. He said, first of all, I went down to the first level and then from first level, I went down to the second level because my train I was to take from there only. Where the suburban trains leave from, ducked into an arched doorway heading for the subway. He said, for the second level, okay, there was arched door, arched entry and I still remember I entered from that entry only, okay, because I wanted to take the train, okay, at the second level. But he said, when I entered from there, this much I remember, and maybe from there I got lost. Okay. That's easy to do. I have been in and out of Grand Central hundreds of times, but I'm always bumping into new doorways and stairs and corridors. He said, from there only I felt that I got lost. And then he says, actually, this is very natural for anyone, at least for me, to get lost. Why? Because this station is so complicated, it's such a big platform, it's such a, because though there are only 2 levels, even then so many entries, so many exit doors, okay, so many things, and such a big complicated station this is, okay, that anybody can get lost. And for me, I must say, I must agree that yes, many times earlier also, okay, I had this kind of experience where I felt that yes, I had taken a wrong maybe side, or I had taken wrong entry, or maybe I exited somewhere else. So this kind of experience he already had many times. But I'm always bumping into new doorways and stairs and corridors. Once I got into a tunnel about a mile long and came out in the lobby of Roosevelt Hotel. So here also he's narrated one experience. He said, yes, once again, okay, earlier also I had got into some tunnel and I wanted to get to some particular platform to train, take the train, but then I reached somewhere else. Okay, so this was the lobby of Roosevelt Hotel. Then another time I came up in an office building on 46th Street, three blocks away. Once again he had maybe taken the wrong route, and then at that time he had reached 46th Street. This is the name of the street. So there only he had reached, though maybe he wanted to go to his office or somewhere else. So he says, actually this station is so big and so complicated, at least for me, that many times, okay, earlier also I was lost. Okay, sometimes I think Grand Central is growing like a tree. Again, two marker you may get, that why he thinks that this station is growing like a tree. Why? Because actually this station is too big, so big, and he always felt that maybe every day this some or the other construction is going on. Okay, means all the things are being multiplied over here. This is what he always felt, that every time new entries are there, every time new exits are there. The thing is, actually it's not that he was coming here every day. If you take a station or take some train from a particular station every day maybe, then you are not that much confused, because you know that, okay, this thing is being, you know, built on this side and this is new building, or this is something new this side only. But if you go after maybe 2 months, 3 months, especially maybe in Delhi also, you might have, you know, noticed these things, that if you go some to some particular place or to particular side, after 2-3 months you feel, my God, so many things are changed. Okay, somewhere this is metro, somewhere subway, somewhere something else. So you feel that, oh my God, everything, some new construction is going on. So this is the same thing he felt for this Grand Central Station. Okay, he always felt that this is growing like a tree, pushing out new corridors and staircases like roots. Okay, he always felt that like roots, it's like big tree, old trees, they are having many roots, okay, going many sides. Okay, so this way he always felt that this train, this Grand Central is also like that big tree, which is having many roots and going many sides. Okay, and sometimes that's why people get confused which side they are supposed to take. There's probably a long tunnel that nobody knows about feeling its way under the city right now. And he feels that, yes, there is a long tunnel also, which is starting from this Grand Central Station and maybe reaching somewhere else, or maybe connecting some other side. And he feels that maybe many people even do not know that there is some this kind of tunnel going, okay, towards the other side, on its time, on its way to Times Square and maybe another to Central Park. And he feels that there are naturally tunnels also, okay, which this station is being linked to the Central Park, or maybe other tunnel to Times Square. This way there are many tunnels also, not only exits and entries only. And maybe because of so many people through the years, Grand Central has become an exit, a way of escape. Now here he talks about, this is very symbolic way. Okay, so he says that maybe this station actually symbolically, or we can say this is very philosophical thing, that he feels that this station has been a kind of exit for many people. Okay, this has been an exit, a way of escape. Now why way of escape? Actually whenever we take the train, sometimes we go to some other town, to our relatives, to our parents, to our friends, okay, to our children. So it means we are away from our hectic schedule for few days. Okay, so this is a kind of escape he feels, that trains always are mean of escape, okay, for people. Why? Because during summer vacations we are leaving behind our hectic schedule and we are forgetting about this, and for 1 week we are going to some hill station or maybe some beaches or something we are going to enjoy. So these stations and these trains actually that way become a mean of escape. So this is what he feels, that this is a way of escape. Maybe that's how the tunnel I got into, but I never told my psychiatrist friend about that idea. And that's, he says that that's why maybe this kind of escape, once I also got, that I got into some tunnel and I reached somewhere else where I never wanted to go. Okay, that was not my destination, but by mistake I reached over there. He says, but about all these experiences, I never talked to my friends, even not to my Sam friend who is psychiatrist. I never told about these things. Okay, because I feel maybe these things are very common. But today, whatever happened, he says, this is not common. Because these people say that this is fantasy only, but I feel no, there was third level and I was, you know, on the third level and I had seen so many different things because it was third level, though people are still not agreeing to this fact that this Grand Central Station is also having third level. They say there are only two levels, But I still say, no, there is third level also, and I had got that experience. I think in this video, this much is enough. Okay, because this is little bit complicated and a little bit sometime, you know, dry chapter for few students. But give it a reading, try to enjoy it, try to understand it. And I hope when I complete this chapter, okay, in the next video, you would certainly start loving this chapter, and maybe you would get maybe the, you know, good marks in this chapter. Okay, so just see you in the next video now with rest of the chapter. Thank you.